This video is sponsored by Audible, which means I put a link down at the top of my description to audible.com/thekingofrandom. Click that link, and by starting a 30-day free trial, you'll get your first audiobook for free. Welcome back. My name is Nate, and I want to thank you for joining me today on The King of Random. Today, we're going to show you how to take a project that we've done before and ramp it up to the next level. In a previous video, we showed you how to make a Matchbox rocket launching kit. So now we're going to take what you learned in that video and step it up to the next level, using simple parts to build a revolver that can shoot 6 rockets in a row. Now, the previous video showing how to make an entire rocket launch pad was actually the first video I ever saw on The King of Random. So I'm really excited to show you how to take these little rockets and turn it into something bigger. There's 2 parts to this build, and the first part is making the rockets themselves. To make the rockets, we need aluminum foil, aluminum tape, a box of matches, and a couple of bamboo skewers. The second part of the build is the revolver itself, and for that, all you're going to need is some cardboard from a cereal box of your choice, some more bamboo skewers, a barbecue lighter, and some small zip ties. The previous Matchbox Rockets video explains in a lot of detail how to make these little rockets, but we're just going to go over the process really quick for you right now. Using the provided pattern, cut the 5-sided shape out of aluminum foil. The previous video shows how you can use paper towel or toilet paper to cut out several of these shapes at once, which is what we're going to want to do since we have several rockets to launch. If you don't include the layers of toilet paper or paper towel between the foil, the edges will curl together and you won't be able to separate your different pieces of foil. The provided pattern shows how far the bamboo skewer should be rolled into the foil rocket. Update guys, we have a bunch of our foil rockets made and we're ready to start building the revolver to launch them off. The first thing you need to do is cut a flat piece of cardboard out of your cereal box. The next step is to figure out what size of circle to cut out of the cardboard for our revolver. On my barbecue lighter, you can see that the flame is a little under 1 inch high. After measuring your flame, measure that same distance from either side of your barbecue lighter. This measurement will give you a good estimate for the spacing of your 6 rocket revolver launch rods. We're going to want to trace out 2 sizes of circles. The first is the size of the measurement you just took, and the other one should be 1/4 to 3/8 of an inch larger in diameter. The best way to do that is with a compass. If you don't have a compass, there are several household items you can use to trace, like a cup, a roll of tape, or the lid to a spray can. You'll want to take the diameter of the measurement and draw 2 circles that size. Now we'll extend our compass by about 1/8 of an inch and draw a second circle around each of our first circles. Now we'll show you a trick to get 6 equally spaced points around your circle so that your rocket launch rods will be equally spaced. Using the measurement of the radius of your first circle, place the point of the compass on the edge of the circle. Mark where your pencil touches the line of your drawn circle, as well as the point where your compass was. Using a drill bit the same size as your barbecue lighter, you want to drill a hole in the center of each of your cardboard circles. With my barbecue lighter, I'm using a 3/8 inch bit. Next, using a drill bit the same size as your bamboo skewers, drill out each of the 6 points around the circle. I find that a 1/8 inch bit is just the right size. If the edges of the holes are a little bit ragged once you've drilled them, just go over them with a little bit of sandpaper. Once you've got all of your holes drilled, you're ready to cut out your circles. Next, find 6 bamboo skewers that are pretty straight, at least on the top half. Trim all of the bamboo skewers about halfway down the tapered point, and then lightly sand the top 2 inches. We've got all of our parts ready and it's time to start assembling, but you know that here at the King of Random we like to decorate, and now is the time to do that. Okay, we've decorated all of our pieces now, let's put it all together. Start pushing your bamboo skewers through the holes that you drilled in both pieces of cardboard. Try to be sure that the tips of the bamboo all reach the same length in front of the cardboard and that the two pieces of cardboard are parallel to each other. Before we permanently attach the skewers to the cardboard, we want to make sure the whole mechanism is properly aligned. To make sure that the extra bits of the bamboo skewer aren't hitting the handle of your lighter while you're doing the alignment, clip everything off about a quarter inch behind the back piece of cardboard. Once you have all of your bamboo skewers inserted and properly aligned, secure them in place with a few drops of super glue. Once the glue is dried, your rocket revolver is almost finished and there's just a couple more details we need to add. You want to move your revolver apparatus to where the point of the bamboo skewers lines up with the tip of the flame. Attach a zip tie to the barbecue lighter, tighten it most of the way, and move it forward until it is pressing against the cardboard circle. Attach a second zip tie right behind it, facing the other direction. Scoot the revolver apparatus up to the front of the barbecue lighter so that you can really cinch the zip ties as tight as they will go. Add one more zip tie to the front of the barbecue lighter, press it up against the cardboard, and cinch it tight. Clip the front zip tie as close to the locking mechanism as you can get. On the back zip ties, you'll want to cut one of them about 1 millimeter above the level of the bamboo skewer and one of them halfway down the bamboo skewer. A couple drops of super glue will secure the two zip ties together and permanently attach them to the barbecue lighter. The two cut zip ties work as a locking mechanism to keep your revolver in place as you switch from one shot to the next. And now your rocket revolver is complete and ready to use. Let's load up those rockets we made before and fire them off.
Now while Nate's getting that set up, let's take a second to talk about Audible. So Audible is an app that I have on my phone. It's one that I use all the time. Professional narrators read books. You can just basically plug in your headphones and listen to audiobooks wherever you go. Now, I know a lot of you go to work, you're taking the car, you're getting stuck in rush hour traffic, or you're waiting for the train. What are you doing with that downtime? Audible is a service that hires professional narrators to read books that you can download, plug in your headphones, and listen to at the bus stop or on your daily commute. So instead of wasting time, now you're improving your time. Jump down to the description, click the link for audible.com/thekingofrandom and sign up for a 30-day free trial. That'll allow you to download an audiobook like this one I'm reading called The E-Myth by Michael Gerber, which I highly recommend. You ever wonder why so many businesses fail or so many YouTubers experience creator burnout? This book really opened my eyes and told me why. As I was reading this book, I related to it, like that is me. But it really is a great service, guys. One of my favorite features is you can listen to the stories on 2x or 3x speed, so you can actually cram information as fast as you can process it in your brain. And I really like that feature a lot. I use it, my wife uses it, and pretty much everyone I know uses Audible. So if you're not on Audible yet, jump down to the description, click the link for audible.com/thekingofrandom and join the club. The book club, as it were. All right, let's jump back and see what Nate's doing.
All right, guys, and here it is, all put together, the rocket revolver. We've got 6 rockets loaded onto the front. We can rotate from one to the next and launch them off one after another. Let's test out what this bad boy can do. There you have it, guys. That's how to take the Matchbox rockets from a previous video and amp it up to the next level so you have your very own rocket revolver. Using this revolver, you can shoot off 6 rockets in a row, which is a lot more firepower. This is a fun build that you can do in not very much time that takes rocketry to a much more mobile level. Check the link in the description below for the template for these rockets and start launching. Thanks for joining me in this project, and I look forward to the next one. Talk to you then.
This is Audible.
Hey guys, just a quick reminder to drop down to the description, click the link for audible.com/thekingofrandom. Really is a great service. I use it, my wife uses it, my brother-in-law uses it, pretty much everyone I know uses it, and I think you'll like it too.
Too much tape. Draw.
I'm a very fast draw. I have very slow bullets.